I'm not gonna beg, but you should share this video. On today's broadcast, Microsoft slashes pricing of another service in an attempt to be your single destination for notes, find out when Word, Excel, and PowerPoint apps may finally be available on the iPad, and how two advisors are giving up on the traditional office space so they can work with clients completely virtually. So get ready, FPPad Bits and Bytes begins now. Hey everyone, I'm Bill Winterberg, and thank you for joining me for this week's Technology News Broadcast. Today's episode is brought to you by Total Rebalance Expert, the industry's largest privately owned portfolio rebalancing software provider. Designed by well-known CPA Cheryl Rowling, TRX features tax-efficient rebalancing, an easy-to-use interface, and more, all at an affordable price. Learn how you can gain a $500,000 return on your technology investment by downloading their latest white paper at fppad.com/TRX. Leading off this week's broadcast is news once again from Microsoft, as the company revealed changes to its note-taking application called OneNote. For the first time, Microsoft released a version of OneNote for the Mac operating system, and it also introduced a freemium version for Windows, replacing the traditional desktop-based version that was priced at around $100. This move increases OneNote's chances of competing against popular note-taking apps like Evernote, Google Keep, and to a lesser extent, Apple's Note application synchronized via iCloud. Notes saved in OneNote are synchronized via Microsoft's OneDrive online file storage service, further deepening users' dependency on Microsoft's array of services. But with support for OneNote apps for iOS, Android, and Windows Phone, you'll have the ability to review and add notes anytime, anywhere, all from the convenience of your mobile device of choice. Also new to OneNote is a library of APIs that will allow third-party apps to integrate with the note-taking service, including an integration for If, or If This Then That, a wildly popular online automation service for single-step workflows. Premium features in OneNote are available if you own Office 2013 or subscribe to Office 365, so be sure to visit fppad.com/125 for the links to all the details. Now, I can't mention Microsoft in a broadcast this week without addressing the rumors surrounding the imminent release of Microsoft Office for iPad. Several news outlets cited unnamed sources who alluded to the release of Office for iPad around March 27th. Since the debut of the iPad back in 2010, users have had access to a number of third-party apps that were somewhat compatible with Microsoft Office documents, including apps like Documents to Go, Office 2 HD, QuickOffice Pro HD, and more. But until now, there's been no native solution from Microsoft that offers many of the robust features users know and love in Office. And using the Office Online Suite, formerly known as Office Web Apps, in the iPad's web browser has been a kludgy solution at best. So if you've avoided using Apple's iWork Suite or Google Drive to manage word processing and spreadsheets on your iPad, you may now finally have the apps you've been waiting for directly from Microsoft. So check the App Store after March 27th to see if Office for iPad is available. And finally, all this talk about notes in the cloud and Office on the iPad, it's a great segue to talk about the virtual office. In a trend worth watching, several advisors are ditching the traditional corporate office environment in favor of a more flexible and low-cost virtual office. Advisors Alan Moore and Sophia Barra were recently featured in a column at Investment News for their approach to running an advisory business without the need for a traditional office. To support his business, Moore highlights a number of apps that help him stay connected with clients. Longtime FPPad subscribers should recognize the online scheduling app from Schedule Once, electronic signature tools by Adobe EchoSign, and my favorite time tracking app called Rescue Time. But Moore also revealed some new apps like Meldium, a password manager for Teams, and TalkWalker, a service similar to Google Alerts that scours the web and notifies you when it finds keywords and phrases relevant to you. Read more about the favorite apps and services used by these virtual advisors, as well as see stories that didn't make this week's broadcast by visiting fppad.com/125 for the links. Remember, Bits and Bytes exist because of the support of our sponsors. So visit Total Rebalance Expert to learn how their rebalancing software can create a return on investment of $500,000 for your business. Visit fppad.com/TRX for more information. So is OneNote your go-to app for note-taking, or do you prefer Evernote or Google Keep? What's your favorite app for running a virtual office? I want to know. Send me a message on Twitter using @BillWinterberg or search for me on Google+. For FPPad.com, I'm Bill Winterberg. See you next time. Learn how you can gain $500,000 return on your technology investment by downloading their app at trx.com that offers many of the robust features users know and love. You should share this video. Don't take that out of context.